Hello my dear students, we have finished our first unit and the name of the unit was the last lesson, though it was our first lesson. Today we are going to start our second lesson, second unit, and the name of the unit is Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. Let's read about the author of the story. The name of the author is Annie Jung and she was born in Rourkela and spent her childhood and adolescence in Hyderabad. She received her education in Hyderabad and in the United States of America. Her parents were both writers. Annie Jung began her career as a writer in India. She has been an editor and columnist for major newspapers in India and abroad, and has authored several books. The following is an excerpt from her book titled Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. These are the stories of such children whose childhood is stolen, is lost somewhere in the state of poverty. Here she analyzes the grinding poverty and traditions which condemn these children to a life of exploitation. Because of this poor situation and traditions, these children have to live the life of exploitation. These are some expressions, new words or phrases which we may come across during the lesson. Look for, it means to search for. Slog the daylight hours, it means to work hard. Roof over his head, वो तो आपको समझ में आ जाएगा. Perpetual state of poverty, it means never ending poverty, it means they are poor forever. Dark hutments, it means temporary house or camps. Imposed the baggage on the child, the responsibilities which these children have to bear on their shoulder for that situation. These phrases used impose the baggage on the child. Sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. This is the expression by a child. Kabhi kabhi mujhe garbage mein rupee milta hai. Why do you do this? I ask Sahib, whom I encounter every morning scrounging for gold in garbage dumps of my neighborhood. Scrounge for, it means to look for. As I told you before that you must note down all these type of phrases and new words. These are very important stuff for your exam. So here also you have read this word look for and the synonym is scrounge for. Koi cheez शोधना, लुक फॉर, इसके लिए क्या फ्रेज हम यूज करते हैं? स्क्राउंज फॉर. व्हाई डू यू डू दिस? आई आस्क साहेब. एनिस जुंग, साहेब नाम का एक लड़का यहाँ पे इस पैराग्राफ में इंट्रोड्यूस कर रही है. वुम आई एनकाउंटर एवरी मॉर्निंग, एवरी मॉर्निंग मैं उससे मिलती हूँ. और वो लड़का क्या कर रहा होता है? Scrounging for gold in the garbage dumps of my neighborhood. Annie Jung के neighborhood में जो garbage dump रहा होता है वहां से वो कुछ शोध रहा है. Rag pickers. Sahib left his home long ago. अभी तो Annie Jung ने जो question किया why do you do this उसका answer नहीं आया. बीच में she is telling us about the past of this boy Sahib. She says that Sahib left his home long ago, set amidst the green field of Dhaka. His home is not even a distant memory. You can be asked in one sentence answer, where is the home of Sahib? So the home of Sahib is set amidst the green fields of Dhaka. Dhaka ke green field ke beech mein Sahib ka home hai. Sahib left his home long ago, set amidst the green field. I'm sorry. green fields of Dhaka. His home is not even a distant memory. He doesn't remember anything about his home, which is situated in the green fields of Dhaka. There were many storms that swept away their fields and homes, his mother tells him. His mother has told their children that because of storms, heavy storms, their homes were swept away, their fields were swept away, and they couldn't live any longer in their native area, and that's why they left Dhaka and they are here in India in search of gold. That's why they left looking for gold in big city where he now lives. Because storms had swept away their fields and their homes, they couldn't live into their native, and they left their native Dhaka and they have shifted in the big city where they were living in those days. They were looking for gold. To look for gold, it means he is not look for gold ornaments or any gold thing. But to look for gold, it means they are searching for money. खाने के लिए जो पैसे की ज़रूरत होती है, इसकी शोध करने के लिए, रोटी कमाने के लिए, they have come into the big cities of India. Now let's go to the first question. Why do you do this? Now answer comes. I have nothing else to do, he mutters, looking away carelessly. कहीं और देखते हुए उसने आंसर किया, I have nothing else to do. मुझे कुछ I have nothing else to do. मैं क्या करूँ इसके बदले. जब एनिस ने लड़कों को गार्बेज में से, कचरे में से कुछ ढूंढते हुए देखा, तो उसने पूछा, आप लोग ऐसा काम क्यों करते हो? तो साहिब ने आंसर दिया, मुझे और कुछ करने के लिए है ही नहीं. गो टू स्कूल, आई से ग्लीबली. मैंने कुछ सोचे समझे बगैर सडनली आई आस्क्ड, गो टू स्कूल. ग्लीबली इट मीन्स विदाउट थिंकिंग. शी आस्क्ड व्हेन ही सेड दैट आई हैव नथिंग एल्स टू डू, आई एम फ्री, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम सर्चिंग समथिंग इन गार्बेज. Then our author said, go to school. I say gleefully, realizing immediately how hollow the advice must sound. Hollow, it means the thing which is not solid. My advice was hollow. There is nothing, any solid background behind this advice, because she was not able to build any school. Go to school. Then Sahib answered, there is no school in my neighborhood. When they build one, I will go. Anis Jung asked Sahib, why do you do this type of work? Sahib replied, I have nothing else to do. Then Anis Jung said, go to school. Sahib immediately answered that there is no school in my neighborhood. When they build, I will go. If I start a school, will you come? I asked. हाफ जॉकिंग, थोड़ी सी मजाक मस्ती में मैंने उसे पूछा, इफ आई स्टार्ट अ स्कूल विल यू कम? येस, ही सेज स्माइलिंग ब्रॉडली. उसके चेहरे पर ब्रॉड स्माइल आ गया. येस, व्हाई आई विल कम. अ फ्यू डेज लेटर आई सी हिम रनिंग अप टू मी. इज योर स्कूल रेडी? इट टेक्स लॉन्गर टू बिल्ड अ स्कूल, आई से. She just half jokingly had told her, okay, if I start a school, will you come? And she accepted the joke, and in reality, and a few days later, he came to Anis Jung and asked the same question, is your school ready? It takes longer to build a school, I say, embarrassed at having made a promise that was not meant. She was feeling embarrassed that she had made a promise which she could not fulfill. And so, in embarrassment, she answered that it takes longer to build a school. School ko build karne mein waqt lagta hai. It is not so easy job. It takes longer to build a school. I say, embarrassed at having made a promise that was not meant. But promises like mine abound in every corner of his bleak world. But प्रॉमिस इज लाइक माइन, मैंने जैसा प्रॉमिस किया था वैसा प्रॉमिस अबाउंड इन एवरी कॉर्नर ऑफ हिज ब्लिक वर्ल्ड. गेट दिस ब्लिक. सॉरी ब्लिक इट मीन्स सैड, होपलेस. मैंने जैसे प्रॉमिस किए, मैंने तो वो जस्ट जोक में प्रॉमिस किया था, लेकिन ऐसे प्रॉमिसेस ये छोटे बच्चे के एम्प्टी और सैड माइंड के एवरी कॉर्नर में गूंज रहा था. बट प्रॉमिसेस लाइक माइन अबाउंड इन एवरी कॉर्नर ऑफ हिज ब्लिक वर्ल्ड. उसकी जो वर्ल्ड थी, उसकी दुनिया थी, वो सैड थी, होपलेस वर्ल्ड थी उसकी. देर वॉज नॉट एनी रे ऑफ होप इन हिज वर्ल्ड. दे वर लिविंग अ लाइफ ऑफ पॉवर्टी एंड इन सच अ ब्लिक वर्ल्ड. वेन अवर ऑथर सेड इफ आई स्टार्ट अ स्कूल विल यू कम, इट वॉज लाइक अ जॉक फॉर अवर ऑथर. बट साहेब हैड टेकन इट वेरी सीरियसली एंड इट वॉज वेरी मच इम्पोर्टेंट रे ऑफ होप फॉर हिम. उसको आशा जग गई कि शायद एनी सून स्कूल खोलेगी तो वो पढ़ेगा, पढ़ लिख कर कुछ बनेगा तो उसका फ्यूचर कुछ बनेगा. इट वॉज अ रे ऑफ होप फॉर साहेब एंड दैट्स वाई शी वॉज नॉट एबल टू फुलफिल द प्रोमिसज एंड दैट्स वाई शी वॉज फीलिंग एम्बेरेस्ड. आफ्टर मंथ्स ऑफ नोइंग हिम आई आस्क हिम हिज नेम. Many months after knowing him for many months, I asked him his name. So, what was his name? Saheb-e-Alam, he announces. He does not know what it means. Saheb-e-Alam, uska naam tha. He didn't know the meaning of it. He does not know what it means. If he knew its meaning, so uska meaning kya hota hai? A lord of universe. साहेब आलम इट मीन्स अ लॉर्ड ऑफ द यूनिवर्स, पूरे यूनिवर्स का लॉर्ड. इफ ही न्यू इट्स मीनिंग ही वुड हैव अ हार्ड टाइम बिलीविंग इट. ये मानने में उसको बहुत तकलीफ होती कि ओहो मेरे नाम का मतलब तो ये होता है और मेरी हालत ये होती है. नथिंग मैचिज. अनअवेयर ऑफ वॉट हिज नेम रिप्रेजेंट्स ही रोम्स द स्ट्रीट विथ हिज फ्रेंड्स. An army of barefoot boys who appear like the morning birds and disappear at noon. Unaware of what his name represents. उसके नाम का मतलब क्या होता है, उसके नाम का what does his name represent, उसके बारे में बिल्कुल he was unaware. उसको कुछ पता नहीं था. He roams the street with his friends. उसके friends के साथ streets he roams in the he moves to roam it means to move here and there in the street with his friends. And it was like an army of barefoot boys. Barefoot boys who appear like a morning birds and disappear at noon. Morning में सब लोग दिखते थे. ये पूरी जो gang थी barefoot rag pickers की, they could be seen in the morning and by noon it disappeared. Over the months, I have come to recognize each of them. थोड़े महीनों, in a few months, she began to recognize each of them. She had become so much familiar. It shows that how kind Annie Chung was. She had deep concern for these children. We don't have to time to look at this type of children who move here and there in our neighborhood also. We seldom look at them. But our author Annie Chung is so kind-hearted lady. She had deep concern for these poor people who didn't have home, who didn't have anything to wear into his feet. And she talked with them, she also knew them by their names and they had become so much familiar to our author. It shows the kind personality of our Annie Chung and that's why she has written so nice kind stories of the children whose childhood is stolen. Why aren't you wearing chappals? I ask one. My mother didn't bring them down from the shelf, he answers simply. She had become very much familiar with many of them and that's why she asked one of the boys that why aren't you wearing chappals? He answered simply that my mother didn't bring them down from the shelf. She said that my chappals are there on the shelf and my mother didn't bring them down. इवन इफ शी डिड ही विल थ्रो देम ऑफ एड्स अनदर. ये छोटे छोटे बच्चे की बातें हैं. सो इनोसेंट चाइल्डहुड दे आर लिविंग. इवन इफ शी डिड ही विल थ्रो देम ऑफ. अगर उसके मम्मी उसको चप्पल शेल्फ के ऊपर से नीचे उतार देगी तो भी वो पहनेगा नहीं. ही वुड थ्रो इट. एड्स अनदर हु इज वेयरिंग शूज दैट डू नॉट मैच. जो दूसरा बच्चा बोला ही वॉज वेयरिंग शूज एंड द शूज डू नॉट मैच विथ हर क्लोथ्स और हिज पर्सनैलिटी. वेन आई कमेंट ऑन इट ही शफल्स हिज फीट. शफल का मतलब क्या होता है? जब वो पैर जमीन के साथ घिसते हैं तो कैसी आवाज होती है, इसको क्या बोलते हैं? शफल बोलते हैं. When I comment on it, he shuffles his feet and says nothing. जब मैं उसको कहती हूँ क्या ये सच बोल रहा है, क्यों आप चप्पल नहीं पहनते हो, तो वो कुछ नहीं बोलता. ही सिर्फ shuffles करता है उसके फीट को. And I want shoes, says a third boy. लेकिन वो तीसरा बच्चा जो वहाँ पे खड़ा था, he said I want shoes. वो has never owned a pair all his life. अपनी पूरी लाइफ में कभी भी उसके पास अ पेयर ऑफ शूज और चप्पल्स नहीं थे. ट्रैवलिंग अक्रॉस द कंट्री आई हैव सीन चिल्ड्रन वॉकिंग बेयरफुट इन सिटीज एंड ऑन विलेज रोड्स. आवर ऑथर सेज दैट व्हाइल ट्रैवलिंग इनटू आवर कंट्री आई हैव सीन चिल्ड्रन हु वॉक बेयरफुट इन सिटीज एंड ऑन विलेज रोड्स. इट इज नॉट लैक ऑफ मनी बट अ ट्रेडिशन टू स्टे बेयरफुट इज वन एक्सप्लेनेशन. इंडिया में जब वो घूमती थी तब शी हैड सीन सो मेनी चिल्ड्रन दे वेर मूविंग बेयरफुट नॉट ओनली इन विलेजेस बट ऑल्सो इन सिटीज. सो शी माइट हैव आस्क्ड समवन अबाउट इट दैट व्हाई दिस पीपल आर मूविंग हियर एंड देयर बेयरफुट. वन ऑफ देम और वन ऑफ द पर्सन्स माइट हैव गिवन हिम हर एक्सप्लेनेशन दैट इट इज़ नॉट लैक ऑफ मनी. इट इज़ नॉट सो दैट दे डोंट हैव मनी एंड दैट्स वाई दे कांट वेयर चप्पल्स. बट देर इज़ अ ट्रेडिशन टू स्टे बेयरफुट. इन लोगों में ऐसी ट्रेडिशन आती है बेयरफुट रहने की, इज वन एक्सप्लेनेशन. आई वंडर इफ दिस इज ओनली एन एक्सक्यूज टू एक्सप्लेन अ वे ऑफ परपेचुअल स्टेट ऑफ पॉवर्टी. Perpetual state of poverty. Perpetual, it means forever. Being always poor, it means perpetual state of poverty. She didn't know what के क्या सच है, but she felt that it was only an excuse. वो तो सिर्फ एक excuse था to explain away the perpetual state of poverty. ये लोग, those who are poor forever, being always poor, just to it was an explain that they don't wear chappals because it is their tradition. It is not so that they don't have money. This explanation was nothing but an excuse to hide a perpetual state of poverty of these children. I remember a story a man from Udipi once told me. At that time she remembered a story that man from Udipi once told her. As a young boy, he would go to school past an old temple where his father was priest. He told that when he was a young boy, he would go to school past an old temple. And old temple mein uske papa, his father was a priest. Pujari the, priest the. Uske piche ek school thi. He used to go there. He would stop briefly at the temple and pray for a pair of shoes. That boy from Udipi, he told that he would stand before the God and prayed for nothing else but for a pair of shoes. 30 years later, I visited his town and the temple, which was now drowned in the air of desolation. Here we can see the picture of the rag pickers. He might be Sahib and it is his gang, his friends. They are his friends. It might be Sahib and this might be the residential area where our author was living. And see, these rag pickers are just holding big bag and they put something precious which they could find from the garbage. Sorry, which was the last sentence? Huh. 30 years later, I visited the town and the temple, which was now down in the air of desolation. 30 years के बाद जब मैं उस गांव में फिर से गई तब मैंने देखा तो वो there was the village was drowned in desolation. It means destruction. And new village she could see. In the backyard where lived the new priest, there were red and white plastic chairs. A young boy dressed in a grey uniform, wearing socks and shoes, arrived, panting, and threw his school bag on a folding bag. When the man from Udupi who had told the story, he was so poor that while going to the school, he prayed for a pair of shoes to the god. After 30 years, when our author went there again, she could see that everything was changed. New priest had come and there were red and white plastic chairs also she could see. Soon a young boy dressed in grey uniform, it means he was coming from school, wearing socks and shoes, arrived panting. Speedily wo jaldi se school se aaya aur quick breath mein aaya and threw his school bag on a folding bed. Looking at the boy, jab maine us bacche ko dekha, she remembered the boy who had prayed for a pair of shoes before 30 years. 30 साल पहले जब एक छोटा बच्चा जिसके पास पेयर ऑफ शूज भी नहीं था और भगवान को प्रे कर रहा था, she remembered that boy. I remembered the prayer another boy had made to the goddess when he had finally got a pair of shoes. एक दूसरे लड़के ने पेयर ऑफ शूज की प्रेयर की थी और फाइनली इन बच्चों को पेयर ऑफ शूज मिल गया. Let me never lose them. The God had granted his prayer. उसकी प्रेयर थी मुझे एक पेयर ऑफ शूज दो और मैं कभी उसे लूज ना करूँ, छोड़ मैं मेरे पास से वो कभी चला ना जाए. इट मीन्स सदा मेरे पास ये पेयर ऑफ शूज रहे. द गॉड हैड ग्रांटेड हिज प्रेयर. यंग बॉयज लाइक द सन ऑफ द प्रीस्ट नाउ वॉर शूज. The prayer which had been made before 30 years was granted by the goddess, and now the boys of that village were able to wear shoes. But many others, like the red pickers in my neighborhood, remained shoeless. Thank God that some people are able to wear shoes, but many red pickers in my neighborhood remain shoeless. देखो ये रैग पिकर्स हैं, यू कैन सी दैट दे आर शूलेस, दे आर बेयर फुट, दे आर नॉट वेयरिंग एनीथिंग इन टू देयर फीट. अवर ऑथर सेज दैट थैंक गॉड दैट द चिल्ड्रन लाइक द सन ऑफ प्रीस्ट नाउ वेर अबल टू वेयर शूज, बट मैनी रैग पिकर्स इन माई नेबरहुड रिमेन शूलेस. माई एक्वेंटेंस विथ बेयर फुट रैग पिकर्स लीड्स मी टू सीमापुर. Acquaintance, it means पहचान. Introduction. With barefoot rag pickers, ये barefoot rag pickers के साथ मेरी जो acquaintance थी, मेरी जो पहचान थी, that led me to सीमापुरी. You might have heard the name of सीमापुरी, it is one of the parts of Delhi. My acquaintance with barefoot rag picker leads me to सीमापुरी. A place on periphery of Delhi, yet miles away from it, metaphorically. Ironically, if we say that Simhapuri is very near to Delhi, metaphor, you know that it is a figure of speech, and we will revise all these figure of speech when we will meet. I know that you might have, some of you might have forgotten them, so we will revise it, so don't worry. So metaphorically, symbolically, if we say that Simhapuri is in the periphery of Delhi, but yet miles away from it. Jo sukh sagvarta, happiness, materialistic happiness which people get in Delhi, the people in Simhapuri, they can't imagine of it. Though Simhapuri is very close to Delhi, it is in periphery of Delhi, but yet metaphorically, symbolically, it is miles away from Delhi. Those who live here are squatters who came from Bangladesh back in 1971. squatters, it means the people who have occupied the land illegally. A person who unlawfully or illegally occupies a place of land, they are called squatters. So those who live here are squatters. आपको ये वर्ड याद रखना है. वो केम फ्रॉम बांग्लादेश बैक इन 1971. साहेब्स फैमिली इज अमंग देम. सीमापुरी वॉज देन अ वाइल्डरनेस. जब वेन शी हैड विजिटेड दैट एरिया, सीमापुरी वॉज अ लैंड ऑफ वाइल्डरनेस. इट मीन्स इट वॉज अनकल्टिवेटेड लैंड, बंजर जमीन थी इन दोज डेज. इट स्टिल इज, स्टिल इट वॉज, इट इज वाइल्डरनेस, बट इट इज नो लॉन्गर एम्प्टी. बट उन दिनों में सीमापुरी खाली था. इट वॉज वाइल्डरनेस, वेरान और स्केटर्ड अनडेवलप्ड अनकल्टिवेटेड लैंड थी. नाउ ऑल्सो इट इज वाइल्डरनेस, बट इट इज नो लॉन्गर एम्प्टी. इन स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ मर्ज विथ रूप्स ऑफ टीन एंड टारपोलिन, डिवॉइड ऑफ सुवेज, ड्रेनेज और रनिंग वाटर, लिव 10,000 रैग पिकर्स. हाउ डू द रैग पिकर्स लिव इन सीमापुरी? लेट्स सी देयर सिचुएशन. इट इज, इट स्टिल इज, इट मीन्स स्टिल इट इज वाइल्डरनेस, बट इट इज नो लॉन्गर एम्प्टी. इन स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ मड, मड कच्ची मिट्टी होती है ना, उसको गंदा मड बोलते हैं. विथ रूप्स एंड तीन टारपोलिन, टारपोलिन इट मीन्स थीक वाटर प्रूफ क्लॉथ यूज फॉर रूफ. रूफ के लिए जो थीक क्लॉथ यूज करते हैं उसको क्या बोलते हैं? टारपोलिन. द पीपल हु आर लिविंग, दे हैव मेड अ हट मैट्स, सॉरी, इन स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मड विथ रूप्स एंड तीन टारपोलिन, डिवॉइड ऑफ सुएज. Devoid of, it means without. They didn't have. It means devoid of sewage, drainage or running water. The these three essential things they didn't have. Which three things they didn't have? Sewage, drainage or running water. Without all these three essential necessities, 10,000 red people live in Simapuri. They have lived there for more than 30 years without an identity, without permits, but with ration cards that get their names on water lists and enable them to buy grain. They didn't have any identity. They didn't have any permit to live in our country, but they had only one thing. They had ration cards and they had water card or water IDs, and that's why they could buy grain. Food is more important for survival than identity. Saheb's mother told that food is more important for survival than an identity. It is a comparative degree. In the exam, you will be asked to change the degree. Food is more important for survival than identity. Now let's turn the sentence into positive degree. An identity is not so important for survival as food. क्या किया मैंने? Comparative का positive किया. An identity is not so important or as important as food for survival. If at the end of day we can feed our families and go to bed without an aching stomach, we would rather live here than in the fields that gave us no grain, says a group of women in tattered saris when I asked them why they left their beautiful land of green fields and rivers. Once our author asked one of the women or a group of women, why did you leave this beautiful land and your green fields and green and rivers? Why did you leave your land? She answered, यहां से उसका आंसर स्टार्ट होता है. If at the end of the day we can feed our families and go to bed without aching stomach, at the end of the day, if वी कैन फीड अवर फैमिलीज, हम अपने फैमिलीज को फीड कर सके, एंड गो टू बेड विदाउट एन एकिंग स्टमक, भूख के कारण पेट में दर्द ना हो और पेट, हमारा पेट की भूख शांत हम कर सकते हैं, हमारे फैमिलीज को हम खिला सकते हैं. एट द एंड ऑफ द डे वी वुड राधर लिव हियर देन इन द फील्ड्स दैट गेव अस नो ग्रेन, हम लोग यहाँ रहना पसंद करेंगे हमारे फील्ड्स जिसने हमें कुछ ग्रेन्स नहीं दिए, क्योंकि बिकॉज ऑफ स्टॉर्म्स, स्टॉर्म्स फ्रीक्वेंटली अटैक्ड दैट एरिया एंड देयर फील्ड्स वेर दे वेर लॉस्ट एंड दैट्स वाई दे कुडेंट ग्रो ग्रेन्स इन देयर फील्ड एंड दैट्स वाई दे हैव कम टू इंडिया. दे स्टार्टेड लिविंग इन सीमापुरी, दे लिव्ड इन वेरी बैड सिचुएशन, दे लिव्ड इन वेरी बैड हट्स. They didn't have any time of basic, any type of basic facilities, yet they were living. So our author asked them, why did you leave your own house, your own fields and rivers? And the lady answered that if at the end of the day hum apne family ko bhookh shant kar sake, hum usko kuch khila sake, then we are happy here. Hum yahan pe acche hain. Hum hamare khet mein वापिस नहीं जाएंगे, जिस खेत में हम एक ग्रेन भी नहीं उगा सकते. वेर एवर दे फाइंड फूड दे पिच देयर टेंट्स एंड दैट बिकम ट्रांजिट होम. ट्रांजिट होम इट मीन्स टेम्पररी होम. जहाँ कहीं भी दे फाइंड फूड, उसको फूड मिले, दे पिच देयर टेंट्स, वो अपने टेंट्स वहाँ पे पिच कर लेते थे और दैट बिकेम ट्रांजिट होम, उसका टेम्पररी होम बन जाता है. चिल्ड्रन ग्रो अप इन देम बिकमिंग पार्टनर्स इन सर्वाइवल. सर्वाइवल, वो सर्वाइवल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग एंड फ्रॉम द चाइल्डहुड द चिल्ड्रन बिकेम द पार्टनर्स ऑफ देयर पेरेंट्स सर्वाइवल. जीना, जिंदा रहने की जो लड़ाई थी वो उसके हिस्सेदार बन जाते थे. And survival in Simapuri means rag picking. What is the definition of survival in Simapuri? So the definition of survival in Simapuri, it means rag picking. Through the years, it has acquired the proportions of a fine art. During these days, during these years, these people have become the expert rag pickers. They have developed an art and they have It has acquired the proportions of a fine art. Garbage to them is gold. It is a very important and ironical sentence. Garbage to them is gold. It is their daily bread, a roof over their heads, even if it is leaking roof. But for a child, it is even more. Through the years, it has acquired the proportions of a fine art. Garbage to them is gold. It is their daily bread. They earn their daily bread from garbage, a roof over their heads. From the garbage, they could buy or they could make a roof over their heads. Though the roof is leaking roof, but yet the roof is there. But for a child, garbage is even more. I sometimes find a rupee, even a 10 rupee note, Sahib says. His eyes lighting up. Sahib ki aankh mein chamak aa jati hai. I sometimes find a rupee and even 10 rupee note from garbage. Then our author says, when you can find a silver coin in a heap of garbage, you don't stop scrounging. For there is a hope of finding more. She said that now our author could understand these children's mentality very well. She said that agar aapko silver coin bhi is garbage heap mein se mil jayega, to bhi you are not going to stop scrounging. Scrounging it means look for, shodhna. You are not going to stop scrounging. Because, for ka matlab yahan pe hota hai, because there is hope of finding more. आपके दिल दिमाग में एक होप है, कल हमें इससे भी ज़्यादा मिलेगा. ये ज़्यादा की लालच, दे डू नॉट कंपेल देम टू स्टॉप देम from scrounging something from the garbage. It seems that for children, garbage has a meaning different from what it means to their parents. अभी हमने देखा कि पेरेंट्स के लिए गार्बेज क्या है, उसकी छत है, उसके खाने के का सामान है, बट चिल्ड्रन के लिए कुछ अलग ही है. फॉर चिल्ड्रन इट इज रैप्ड इन वंडर. ये सब स्टफ आपके एग्जाम के लिए इम्पोर्टेंट है. वॉट इज गार्बेज फॉर पेरेंट्स एंड वॉट इज गार्बेज फॉर चिल्ड्रन. तो फॉर चिल्ड्रन इट इज रैप्ड इन वंडर एंड फॉर द एल्डर्स इट इज अ मीन ऑफ सर्वाइवल. बच्चों के लिए ये कुछ ऐसा है, वो वंडर, इट इज रैप्ड इन वंडर, बट फॉर एल्डर्स इट इज अ मीन्स ऑफ सर्वाइवल. वन विंटर मॉर्निंग आई सी साहेब स्टैंडिंग बाय द फेंस्ड गेट ऑफ नेबरहुड क्लब वॉचिंग टू यंग मैन ड्रेस्ड इन वाइट प्लेइंग टेनिस. वन मॉर्निंग अवर ऑथर सीज साहेब एंड वॉट वॉज साहेब डूइंग, ही वॉज स्टैंडिंग बाय द फेंस्ड गेट ऑफ द नेबरहुड क्लब watching two young men dressed in white playing tennis. Two young men were playing tennis in white dress of in a club, and our sahib was standing by the fenced gate and he was looking at the at these two men who were playing tennis. I like the game, he hums, content to watch it standing behind the fence. Ye bahut hi important sentence hai friends. Content to, it means satisfied with. He was looking at some two men, they were playing games, and he said that I like this game, but he was contented, he was satisfied just in watching, standing behind the fence. Fence ke piche se wo sirf dekh raha tha, aur he was contented, he was satisfied, he was very much happy. Ye sahib ki personality ki achha hi batata hai. I go inside when no one is around, he admits, he accepts. ये देखिए, our Anis Chung is doing interaction with Sahib. मैं कभी कभी, I happen to go inside when no one is around, the gatekeeper lets me use the swing. ये gatekeeper मुझे swing use करने देता है, मैं कभी कभी जाता हूँ, he admits. Sahib too is wearing tennis shoes that looks strange over his discolored shirt and shoes. On that day, when our author was talking with that boy, Sahib too was wearing tennis shoes. But they were not normal tennis shoes. They looked strange over his discolored shirt and shoes. Someone gave them to me, he says in the manner of explanation. जैसे वो explanation दे रहा था कि हाँ मैंने तो कहीं से चुराया नहीं है. Someone has given them to me. The fact that they are discarded shoes of some rich boy who perhaps refused to wear them because of a hole in one of them. There was a hole in one of the shoes and they might be the pair of some rich boy who had just discarded them and who had denied or refused to wear them because there was a hole in one of them. For one who has walked barefoot, but एक ऐसा बच्चा फॉर द होल लाइफ वो हैज वॉक्ड बैरफुट, इवन शूज विथ अ होल इज अ ड्रीम कम ट्रू. ही डिडंट माइंड अ होल इन द शूज एंड व्हाई, बिकॉज ही हैड वॉक्ड बैरफुट पूरी लाइफ. जिसने विदाउट चप्पल्स वॉक किया हो, एक होल, अ होल इन अ शूज, शूज में एक छोटा सा होल था, ऐसा शूज भी ऐसे बच्चों के लिए ड्रीम कम ट्रू, जैसे उसका पूरा स्वप्न आज सच हो गया. बट द गेम ही इज वॉचिंग वॉज इंटेंटली इज आउट ऑफ हिज रीच. येस, ही कुड गेट टेनिस शूज विद दो विच वॉज डिस्कार्डेड बाय एनी रिच बॉय, बट द गेम ही वॉज वॉचिंग वॉज आउट ऑफ हिज रीच. दिस मॉर्निंग साहेब इज ऑन हिज वे टू द मिल्क बोर्ड. In his hand is a steel canister. आज तक हमारे ऑथर ने साहेब को देखा है अपने पीठ के ऊपर बड़ा सा एक प्लास्टिक बैग. But on that day, she just saw that there was a steel canister in his hand. साहब सेड दैट आई नाउ वर्क इन टी स्टॉल डाउन द रोड. मैंने स्टार्ट किया है टी स्टॉल में काम करना. ही सेज पॉइंटिंग इन द डिस्टेंस आई एम पेड 800 रुपीज एंड ऑल माई मिल्स एंड एट द टी स्टॉल ही गॉट और ही वॉज पेड 800 रुपीज पर मंथ एंड ऑल हीज मिल्स. दिस इज इन डज ही लाइक द जॉब आई आस्क. क्या आपको ये जॉब पसंद है? His face, I see, has lost the carefree look. Up till that day, our author could see a carefree look on the face of Saheb, but that carefree look was lost on that day. The steel canister seems heavier than the plastic bag he would carry so lightly over his shoulder. अभी हमने वो स्केच देखा था. साहेब was carrying a big plastic bag on his back. Though it was heavy, but it was his own bag. He was the master or he was the owner of that bag. The steel canister seems heavier than the plastic bag he would carry so lightly over his shoulder. Why was this different? Apparently, the plastic bag was bigger. It was full of garbage and he was bending while he was carrying the bag, and the canister was so small, but yet the canister was heavy. Why was this difference? What is the difference behind these two things? The bag was his. Jo bag thi wo Saheb ki apni bag thi. He was the owner of the bag and the canister belongs to the man who owns the tea shop. Aur canister kiska tha? It was the owner of the tea shop. It belonged to the owner of the tea shop. Saheb is no longer his own master. Aur ab Saheb apna khud ka malik nahi raha. Uska malik badal gaya. The owner of the tea shop was his master. He had lost his carefree look. Uske chehre par wo carefree look tha, wo lost ho gaya tha. And now Saheb has lost this joy and his carefree life. And now he had started the job at the tea stall. This is the end of our first part. In next video, we will start our second part. Till then, goodbye. Thanks for watching the video. Stay home, stay safe. Bye.